sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Arabic documents make it clear that in medieval times, Manding-speaking Africans traveled to the Americas. These Africans came from the ancient Mali Empire. In Africa, the Manding lived in large villages in medieval times. At this time, the Manding lived on mounds, with their circular huts made of stone and wood on the top. Their fields were tilled each day. The houses were clustered together in compounds organized around a family head and his married sons. The houses were round. The Manding lived in mounds along the Niger rivers. The mound cultures of ancient America were built by Africans, primarily Manding. The people of the Niger Delta formed riverine communities, which were partly vegetation with some aquatic animals were eaten. The tomb of a Manding king, chief or family head, was usually situated below the surface of the ground. Directly above the sepulchre was another house within the tomb which sometimes contained additional bodies. The ships or canoes plowing down the Niger were operated by the bozo and sorko, fishermen. The bozo lived along the western arm of the Niger bend. The sorko people, who spoke Songhai language, submitted to Manding rule. The bozo and sorko were the masters of the Niger River transport. Many of the ships of the Niger could carry burdens of 60 to 80 tons. These canoes were 90 to 100 feet long. The men usually sat three abreast, with ease. Around 40 men paddled. The Manding warriors used spears, spear throwers, bows, and arrows. The farmers used axes, hoes, and scythes. The Manding wore woven cotton breeches, or simply a girdle. The men often wore sandals. 1312, Emperor Abubakari Muhammad of Mali gave his throne to Mansa Musa and embarked with his fleet into the Atlantic Ocean in search of the continent opposite Africa. Archaeological and epigraphic evidence indicates that Abubakari and or members of his expedition settled in pre-Columbian Brazil. Around AD 1310, thousands of Manding speakers arrived in the Americas from ancient Mali. The mariners from Mali during the reign of Abubakari made transatlantic voyages. Al-Amari obtained his information from Mansa Musa, who was handed the kingship of Mali by Abubakari when he set out to colonize the Americas. Mansa Musa said that Mansa Abubakari would not believe that it was impossible to discover the limits of the neighboring sea, the Atlantic. Musa told Al-Amari that, so he sent out 200 ships equipped and filled with men and the same number filled with gold, water, and enough food to last them for years. Muhammad Abubakari commanded that the captain not return until the supplies were exhausted. After some time, according to Mansa Musa, a single ship returned and the captain was ordered to report his findings. "Prince," he replied, "we sailed for a long time up to the moment when we encountered in mid-ocean something like a river with a violent current. My ship was last. The others sailed on, they disappeared and did not come back." "But the Emperor Abubakari did not believe him," continued Musa. "He equipped 2,000 vessels, 1,000 for himself, and 1,000 for water and supplies. He conferred power on me, Mansa Musa, and left with his companions on the ocean." Upon arrival in America, the Manding sailed along the coast until they found rivers like the Orinoco in Venezuela and Amazon in Brazil, which they used to move into the inland parts of South America. Along these rivers, the Manding have left many inscriptions to point the way to good campsites for Abubakari and the main expeditionary force. Many of these inscriptions have been found along the Rio Chao River in the state of Alagoas in Brazil. These inscriptions are of two kinds. One group of inscriptions were meant to warn the Manding expeditionary force not to camp in certain areas. Inscriptions in this category are found at Piracaba, Brazil. Another group of inscriptions were left in areas suitable for settlement. Once a safe place was found for settlement, the Manding colonists built stone cities or mound habitations. One of these lost cities was found in AD 1753 by Bandeiristas, bandits. These inscriptions were found in the state of Bahia, Brazil by Padre Teles Meneses, in Marajo near the Parauacu and Una rivers, engraved over a mausolea. They tell us that the personage buried in the tomb was named P.E. the most startling evidence of Malians in Brazil is the Brazil tablet, discovered by Colonel P.H. Fawcett in an unexplored region near the Culhuin River. The personage in this tablet was an elite of Malian colony in Brazil. Evidence suggesting a Manding origin for the Brazil tablet are 1. The crown worn by the personage on the tablet, 2. The Manding inscriptions inscribed across the chest and feet of the figure on the tablet, and 3. The evidence of breeches similar to the Manding style worn by the personage depicted on the tablet. The decipherment of these inscriptions detail the burial place and cause of death of a Mansa. It appears that the Mansa on the Brazil tablet was named B. It tells us that B was buried in a hemisphere tomb.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.